With the new 3D mammogram technology, Cindy thought this would replace the additional MRI she was already getting. She skipped the MRI 1 year, but at the urging of the radiologist this past year, suggested that she still get an MRI. He was very persistent. Otherwise, she would not have scheduled or felt she needed one.
They called me back on my anniversary, August the 24th, and they said I needed to come in and get the results. So I was at work, and I know I just turned so red and got so hot and just thought, oh my God, I'm gonna faint. Because I know when they call you back and they don't tell you on the phone that this, I know it's not good. So they scheduled me for biopsies. I was going to go to the beach, and I wasn't going to cancel on the beach this year because all of us were going together, and it was the first year the entire family was going together. So I called my husband at work and said, just meet me at home because they wanted us to come in that day, and he did. And I called the girls because I knew they were together. I knew they were eating lunch.
Pretty much finished eating lunch, so we just left. She tries to not tell us first, but we knew something was wrong.
Yeah,
ugly cried the whole way. Ugly
cried. We went there, and Casey kept saying, everything's gonna be okay, everything's gonna be okay. And Brittany's saying, they never make you come in for okay. It was a lot of tears on the way down because we've been through it. You know, we've had a lot of family stuff, so we kind of been through it.
Cindy had two biopsies performed on each breast. The test results were positive for cancer in her left breast. The doctor diagnosed this as ductal carcinoma in situ, which is the most common type of non-invasive breast cancer. But having DCIS can increase the risk of developing an invasive breast cancer later on.
Mm-hmm. And pretty much in my mind, I already knew what I was going to do when I heard it. Just because I've watched my sister pass away and how it was devastating. So anyway, then when I read my report, because that's, I hadn't seen it myself yet, and I saw all the places that were suspicious, I asked the doctor, can you promise me these other five places are negative? And he said no, he couldn't promise me that. And I said, well, I want to do a bilateral mastectomy.
Throughout it all, Cindy has remained calm and understanding and accepted everything that is going on with her battle now with cancer.
And it was weird because they were all so upset when I got the results, and I was just like, I guess because it was me, I can't really explain why, you know, I have a big faith in God, but and I don't want to say it wasn't him because it sure enough could have been, but it's just that it just didn't bother me. I mean, it was what it was, and they said it was really early, and I have faith that they're going to get it out and that I won't have to deal with it ever again, but I worry about them. I think right as I was being wheeled out into surgery, I think Casey hugged me, and what was your last words to me?
Or
bad
bitch, or
and the nurses just kind of looked at
like,
her.
Oh.
We all have that.
Cindy was amazed at how she felt after the surgery.
Mislead anybody, but it was totally different than what I had expected. I just really expected to be in severe pain, to not be able to get up, to not be able to do anything. But that night when they took me to the mother room, I was able to get up and go to the bathroom.
Cindy had a genetic test for cancer risk when Rhonda developed breast cancer. The screenings show that she did not have the hereditary cancer gene. But since that testing, scientists believe that there might also be other genes that can cause hereditary breast and ovarian cancer. Cindy would like to have another genetic testing done now that scientists have found even more reasons or even more tumors that give her daughters an opportunity to know the likelihood that they will also be carrying the genetic gene.
Yeah, and then if she has a daughter, and then all our cousins. It just seems like 5 women in our family. My sister, she never talked about, we rarely talked about it at all. It was almost like it was that, if we don't talk about it, it won't be here. And I had tried to be the total opposite. It said it could be different because her boys were so young.
She was young.
Yes.
And hadn't really had experience with it. It was all new.
Right. Because she was only 42.
Sometimes everything is wrong.